Good day, good day, good day, everyone. Good day, good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon. It is a Friday. Woo! Thank you so much for joining us today. You are just in time for English Home Language for Grade 7. Yes, thank you so much for joining us today. Let us see who is with us. If you are there, please say hi in the chat. Let's see who is present. Let us see who is absent. Let's quickly take the register. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you. I see a lot of hi's in the chat. I see some regular names and some few new names. You are all welcome. You are all welcome. This is the best thing for you to do on a weekday, on a Friday, 31st July 2020 at 1 p.m. Thank you so much for joining us. So today's lesson will be about transactional texts, but our focus will be on filling forms. Okay. So yes, that will be what our focus today will be on. You would realize that the ability to fill in forms correctly is very, very, very important. Even us here, we are the product of being able to fill in forms, you know, from filling in forms when you apply to go to a university, you know, filling forms for a bursary, filling forms to apply for employment, you know, filling forms, you know, it's all about filling forms these days, you know, filling forms for everything now. Yeah. So anyway, since that being the case, it's so important for you to learn to fill forms. Yes, I know you may think that you are too young for that, but I can guarantee you that you really are not that young anymore. Yes. Yes, I know some of you want to play sports. Some of you want to be in the performing arts, whatever it is that which are your career aspirations, you will need to fill in some forms. Therefore, it is very important for you to be able to do that. And that is why we have this lesson today. As I've said, today's lesson, we will be learning about how to fill in a form. And do you remember what we did yesterday? Yesterday, we did a listening comprehension. Thank you again for all you did yesterday, the questions you were answering. So you'd realize that even today's lesson is so much connected with yesterday's listening comprehension. Remember that in yesterday's listening comprehension, we were reading about the importance of questionnaires, you know. Yes, and filling in forms has so much to do also with questionnaires. Sometimes you may be required to fill in a questionnaire, but most of the times you will be required to fill a form. Therefore, it is very important to be able to fill both of them. It will really be good for you to be able to do that. Yes. So yes, this is what we are doing today. I will be letting you know why you need to learn to fill forms. I know some of you're probably confused why you need to learn this at your age. You know, you think you are too young to be learning this, but I'm telling you, you really are not. Okay. Okay, you are young, but not too young to fill in the form. Okay, and you will also learn about what you need to know to fill in a form. And you'll also learn about how to fill in a form. And I'll also show you an example of a form which is filled in. All right, yeah. So that is what today's lesson is about. Okay, it's interesting, isn't it? Yeah. Interesting lesson for the start of your weekend. Yes. So that is what today's lesson will be all about. And you know, like always, I welcome questions. If you have questions, if you have comments about the content of our lesson, please never hesitate to ask. You can raise your hand and I will give you a chance to speak, or you can write in the chat. Okay, yes. So you really have no reason, you really have no excuse to not understand anything in today's lesson because I'm here for you. And all the channels for you to ask your questions are open. Okay, so is there anyone who would like to read the introduction for us? Please raise your hand. Anyone to read the introduction for us? Raise your hand and I'll give you a chance to read the introduction for us. Someone, anyone? Thank you, Zetu. Hi, Zetu. Zetu? Hello, Zetu.
It's me, Kanye.
Oh, hi, Kanye. How are you?
Fine, yourself?
I'm good. Thank you so much for raising your hand. I realize that this is your first time you're joining us.
No, I've joined. It's been a few days, a week already. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Wow. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for joining us for the past week. I hope you've learned a lot and I hope you've been enjoying your learning. Thank you again for raising your hand. Can you please read the introduction for us?
Okay, it says, filling in forms and questionnaires is a very crucial skill, especially for your academic and professional future.
Yes, thank you. Thank you so much, Kanye, right? Thank you. Thank you so much. So yes, that is the thing about forms and questionnaires. You really need to get to that place where you are able to fill them in and to fill them in correctly, because this is very important for your academic future as well as for your professional future, you know. Because sometimes a very sad thing will be if you apply for a job opportunity, for a bursary, a sponsorship, whatever it is that you should be applying for, chances sometimes is that your application becomes unsuccessful. Not because you are not qualified, not because there's something bad about you, not because of any other reason, but simply because you did not fill in everything well, okay? And I can also tell you by my own personal experience that I really have worked at an office before. Therefore, I know how frustrating it is to be able to see forms which are not filled in properly. Chances are some people, when they see those things, what they do is that they shred them, you know. They can really shred them, they can trash them, you know. Some can even drink tea on them, you know. I mean, can you imagine someone drinking tea on top of the form that which you filled in? It is very sad, you know. It is very, very sad, you know. It is very sad. I know it may sound funny right now, but it is very sad, and that is something that we should do not want it to happen to you. Therefore, that is why there is this lesson to make sure that you do not do such mistakes, okay? To make sure that you do not do such mistakes. They are not good to make, because the consequences of such mistakes, they are too serious, you know. They are very, very far-reaching, you know. We do not want you to miss out on the opportunity of being the next big thing in the music industry, the next big thing in medicine, in business, in education, in whatever, simply because you did not fill in your form or your questionnaire correctly, okay? So that is why we are having this lesson to teach you so that you can be equipped and enabled to be able to fill in forms and questionnaires correctly. That is a very important skill, all right? Yes, it will help you in your academic life and also in your professional future, no matter it is that which you want to be. Okay. All right, let's continue. So filling in forms, okay. So yes, as I have said, I know some of you are wondering about the reason why. Why do you need to fill a form? Why do you need to learn to be able to fill? So you need to learn how to fill a form. Okay, that is the most basic reason. Simply because there will be a time where you will need to fill in a form, okay? I know that now you are in grade 7. Next day you're going to grade 8. And chances are that it will be your brother or your sister, your uncle, your aunt, or your parents who will be filling in the form for you, okay? But even if it is that way, it really doesn't hurt for you to be able to fill the form, okay? And it will really be excellent that when they are filling in the form for you, you are sitting there with them, you know. I know sometimes our parents can really make some mistakes, you know, and they think that they, okay, not because our parents are bad people, you know. We know that our parents, they love us, and your parents love you. And I can really tell you that No matter how you feel about your parent right now, I can really assure you that they really have good intentions for you. They really have good intentions for you. They really, deep down, they really want you to have a bright future. They really want to look at you and be proud of you and to really brag about you to their friends, to their colleagues, and to other relatives in the family that, you see, that is my child, that is my son, that is my daughter, you know, one, two, three things about her, one, two, three things about him. So that is the thing about our parents, okay? So what I'm trying to say here is that even when your parents are feeling in the form for you, I recommend that you be there. There are some feels that which parents, they do not know what to feel, okay? And if they can make a mistake, it can really work against you. Therefore, it will really be good for you to be able to know how to feel it in the form, so that if you can see your parents about to make that mistake, then you can really stop them from making it. So yes, the most basic information is because you need to learn how to fill a form, okay? Chances are that maybe in the next 2 years, you will be at a place where your parents are not there. Maybe because you've relocated, therefore they cannot really help you to fill a form. Then it will be you who will need to fill in a form. What if then after this lesson, you go to a grocery store and you see this opportunity where you need to fill in a form and the closing date is today? What then? If the closing date is today at 6 and your parents, they knock off at work at 7, what then? Are you going to wait for them? But by the time your parents are home, it will have been the closing date, okay? Therefore, you really need to be at the place where, even without your parents, you can be able to fill in a form. And that's what today's lesson is about. So yeah, that is important. You need to be able to learn to fill in a form. And I remember when I was preparing this lesson, I really had mixed emotions, you know, because when I was in grade 7, we didn't learn this, okay? I really learned to fill in a form. I think it was in grade 12, all right? When I was in grade 12, that was when I was able to fill in a form. That is when we were filling in forms to register to write the final year exams. Yes, you see, so look at you now. You are learning this in grade 7. When you are 12, 13, 14, and I learned this when I was 17 or 18. Yeah, see, so that is how important that this really is, because now things have changed. Now things have changed, especially since they say that after grade 9, you can go to a college, you know. Therefore, you see that this means that you should be able to get to a place where you are able to fill in a form at an earlier stage. Yes, with your parents' permission, of course, okay? Yeah. And here we have Khami in the chat saying that they fill in a questionnaire every day at school because of COVID-19. You see? So now being able to fill in a questionnaire, we have Amo saying that because of the COVID-19 situation, they fill in a questionnaire every day at school. You see? So you really need to be able to fill in the questionnaire, because the information you give in a questionnaire, we really need it. You know, it is so important. Yes, it is so important. All these statistics that which you see, they are based on the information you give in questionnaire. So then if you do not know how to fill in a questionnaire, or if you give incorrect information in the questionnaire, then you are really making the news to report false information. You see, so it is very important. We really need right and correct information. Okay, another reason is that you are required to give specific information when you fill in a form, okay? Yes, chances are, even let's say right now I'm a CEO of a company and, you know, I really feel very generous because of the COVID-19, and I want to give some of you sponsorships to go to school next year, you know? So what I will do is that I will draft the form and give it to you to fill in. That is the only way for me to be able to get specific information from you. Remember, I do not know any of you. The only way I could know you is if I could really give you a form for you to sign the form, you know, fill in your names, your career aspirations, your age, your ID number, and all the information that which I will be requiring. You see, so that is why it is so important to be at a place where you're able to fill in a form. What you need to know to fill in a form. So is there anyone who can think of a reason why you need to be able to fill in a form? Is there any other reason you are thinking of which I didn't mention? Please raise your hand and tell us the reason. so that we can add to the ones we already have. What do you think will be one more reason why it is important for you to be able to fill in forms? So these are the reasons why you need to be able to fill in a form, okay? Yes. So anyway, here is what you need to know to fill in a form. Number one, remember, you are required to give specific information when you fill in a form, okay? So you will realize that we are asked, in a form, we are asking for specific information, okay? We are not asking everything about you. We are not asking about what you had for breakfast today. We are not asking about what you are hoping to have for supper today since this month. And we are also not asking you about all those other things which may not be relevant. But you realize that every form is asking for specific information from you. Okay. For example, if I am giving you a bursary form, then I will want to get specific information about you in the form. Information such as, who do you live with, okay? And how much money do they make, were you in your household, you know? Why then should we give you this bursary? You know, all those things, that is, those are the specific information that which we need, okay? Yes. So anyway, the specific information that is required, it will depend on what is the purpose of the form. Okay, so in this, in my example, if the form is a bursary, remember, a bursary really has to do with studying and money. Therefore, in that form, it will ask you something about the course you want to study, the institution where you will want to study, as well as your career aspirations. Yeah. Okay, so you see, but if the form, maybe it is about, let's say it is a form for a high school. Now that you are in primary school, you are in the last grade in primary school. Next day you have to go to high school. So in that form, then we'll be asking questions about, you know, we will want to know about your academic performance in grade 7. We will want to know about your age. We will want to know about all this. We will want to know about your age. Yes, we will want to know about all these things that which have something to do with you going to grade 8, you know. We will also want to know about who will be paying your school fees, you know, who are you living with at home, what is your address so that we can see how far you live away from the school, things like that. So you will realize that each and every form asks for specific information in relation to what the form is about. So a bursary form, it will not ask the same information as a school application form. You see, yes. Another thing is that, okay, make sure to carefully follow all the instructions. So make sure to carefully follow all the clear given instructions. Okay, so therefore you'll realize that with most forms, the first page will be instructions, okay? They will tell you that, you know, use a black pen to fill the form. Some forms will also tell you whether to use uppercase letters or lowercase letters, you know. Some forms, they will tell you, yes, they will really give you instructions what to do. You know, use a black pen, use a blank ink pen, use uppercase letters, you know, do not use T-Pex, do not use a pencil, attach your supporting documents, you know, all those. So make sure that every instruction that which is given to you, make sure that you follow it. There is a reason why, there is a good reason why you need to follow those instructions. If you do not follow those instructions, chances are that your application may not be successful. Chances are that there will be someone who will be having a bad day at work in the office. When they get your form, they're going to drink tea on it and it won't reach where it needs to go. Okay. So please make things easy for yourself by following all these instructions, and also make things easy for the administrator, for the receptionist, for whoever person who will be going through your form after you have filled it in. Okay, so make things easy for everyone. We know that life is challenging, life gets hard sometimes, okay? Therefore, make things easy for everyone, make things easy for yourself by following those instructions. Okay, remember also to provide the correct information, okay? Please, this is very, very, very important. If my name is Jackie, I was born on 24 July 2005. Please, 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 even in the form, when they say date of birth, say 24 July 2005, okay? Do not say 18 July 2005 simply because you love Mandela and you want your birthday to be in the same day as Nelson Mandela. No, we do not work like that, okay? We do not work like that. Plus, remember, with every form that we should be filling in, they will be wanting supporting documents, okay? So if I'm born on the 24th of July 2005, even my birth certificate will be having that, okay? So therefore, you see then that if I'm going to write 18 July 2005 because I love Mandela and I want to share the same, I want my birthday to be the same day as his birthday, you see, then you are creating problems for yourself. You are also creating problems for the person who will be receiving your form, okay? Because they will see that the information you provided on the form, it is not the same as the information on your supporting documents. Therefore, you may get disqualified for that, okay? So please, I'm begging you, you know, okay? I'm begging you, I am literally on my knees right now. I am literally on my knees right now. I'm begging you, please, provide the correct information, okay? And I know another thing, okay? I am really guilty of this one. That, okay, you know, in my identity document, my name Jackie is written with a Y, but I love to write my name JK with an IE. Okay, so then usually in the past, what I would do, I will write my name JK with IE because I really love it with an IE. You know, I used to believe that the JK with a Y is a girl's name and the JK with an IE is a boy's name. You see, so then when I go to matric, then I asked one of my teachers what I should do. Then my teacher told me that I should really write my name the way it is written in my identity document so that there will not be any misinterpretations, any misunderstandings, you know. So from then on, that is how I would fill in my forms, okay? I would make sure that I write JK with the IE. But then if you and I can chat on social media, you ask me what is my name, I will tell you that my name is JK with an IE because I really like it like that. But then when I fill in forms, I use the Y because it is very important to make sure that you provide the correct information. Even when I go to Home Affairs, you know, even when I apply to things online, if I put in my ID number, it will reflect my name JK with a Y, you see? So please do not fall into that mistake because it may create problems for you. And even today, I am so thankful that my teacher really, really helped me with that. I do not know where I would be right now if it wasn't for him. Yes. So please remember, provide the correct information, okay? If you live in Pretoria, please write a Pretoria address, okay? Do not write a Cape Town address because you would like to live with your aunt in Cape Town. No. You are living with your parents in Pretoria. Therefore, write your Pretoria address where you live with your parents. Do not write the Cape Town address because you love your aunt more than your parents and you want to live with your aunt from next year, you see? So no, make sure that you provide the correct information and make sure that the information that which you provide, it will be the same information that which is contained in your supporting documents, all right? Yes, please, that is very important. I can never stress that enough, you know? If it was possible, I was going to come to each and everyone's room right now and tell you, please provide the correct information. Just a little bit of a slap, you know, just to wake you up. Yeah. So that was I was going to do if that was possible. But what I can do is to just beg you, you know, is to just be calm and, you know, ask you gently, you know. Yes. Okay. Also, what you need to know is fill in the sections of the form which are relevant to you. Okay. You realize that in many forms, there is this section where it says office use. Okay. You know that it is not, you know that you are not working in the office. Please do not fill anything there. Okay. So that section which says for office use, it is for where that form you are sending it to. The people who work in that office, they will fill it. You know, yes. Remember, I did say I did work in an office previously. Therefore, if then I see you, Amu, I see you, Huapele, I see you, Angelina, whoever, I see you. You have filled in under the office use only column. I will be very frustrated, you know. I'll be very frustrated with you. And if I'm going to call you, you are not going to have a good day. Even if I'm going to call you on a Friday and I'm having a bad day on that Friday, you are not going to have a good day. I will make sure that I will ruin your day because you have ruined mine by filling in the form on office use only when it was supposed to be me who should feel there. I mean, you know how that feels like. That feels like you are taking away my food. You know, I know that at 2 p.m. it's going to be my lunchtime and someone has bought me pizza for that, and then you are taking my food. So it does feel like that. So please make sure you fill in the relevant sections. Okay. Some forms will also tell you that, okay, if you are a girl, fill section A. If you are a boy, fill section B. So please, if you are a girl, please fill section A. Do not fill section B. All right? I do not want to know how you feel about boys as a girl. I do not want to know how you feel about girls as a boy. But please, 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 if we say girls, fill section A, please fill section A as a boy. Boys, fill section B, please fill section B as a boy, okay? And then also, if it happens that you are a minor, okay, a minor is someone under the age of 18. You are in grade 7. I know you are under the age of 18 because you're in grade 7. So then, if it says that it wants your parent's signature, if you are a minor, please do not, please, please, please do not sign for yourself. Give your parents to sign for you, okay? And then, if it says that if you are a minor, do not sign. Then please, you are a minor. You are 13 years old. You are in grade 7. Please. Do not sign, okay? Please, all right? Please. This is important, okay? I can see a lot of smile emojis in the chat. I know this is very funny. Yes, it's funny now, okay? So let us make sure that it is funny only right now in the lesson, because if everything I'm telling you now happens in real life, in your own life, you won't be laughing. Instead, you will be crying, and I will not be there to say I told you so. I will not be there to give you a hug to say it will be okay. Yeah, chances is that I will be happy somewhere, you know, doing my own thing. Yeah, so please make sure that it is funny only here in the lesson. Make sure it doesn't happen in your own life, because if it happens in your own life, you will not enjoy it because it is not funny. Okay, so make sure that in the forms which are relevant to you. Okay, yeah. So if you say that section D, it is for people in sports, then you do not play sports. Please do not fill section D, okay? Simply because you are a big soccer fan. Please don't. Then also what you need to know, make sure that you use formal language. I can never stress this one enough, okay? Please make sure that you use formal language, okay? You are talking to people in the offices. People in the offices, they do not use LOL unless they are online on social media. I can tell you, you know, even myself, when I was still working in the office, if a colleague will make a joke, I will laugh. Wow, really? Wow. You see, that will be how I was laughing, you know. There was never a time where a colleague will say a funny story and I'm like, LOL, you're so funny. Hey, LOL, 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 you're so funny. LMAO, LMAOL, wow, you're so funny. No, there's never been such a time. Usually in an office, we are expecting formal language, even in your form, okay? We are expecting that you use a formal language, all right? Please, please, please. If there is a section in the form where you need to write a paragraph, please do not say, please, 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 do not say BTW, okay? Please, what is BTW? What is BTW? Okay, I know that BTW is, by the way, maybe I may be forgiving if it happens that your form will be processed by me. But chances are, what if your form will be processed by that 50-year-old woman who doesn't know what TBW is? You see, you are shooting yourself in the foot. So please make sure that you use formal language, okay? Make sure that you use formal language, because formal language is very important. Everybody knows formal language, okay? Everybody knows formal language. So please use formal language. It will work for you. And I can really tell you that it will really work for you. So please use formal language. So that is what you need to know, okay? Make sure that you use formal language, okay? Please. And then if it happens, maybe that there is a question about your social media pages. They are asking which social media you are on. If you have Instagram, please do not say IG. Please, just write it in full, Instagram. If you have Facebook, do not say FB. Please write it in full, Facebook. I know this sounds too good to be true, but then I remember I once filled in a scholarship form where they asked about my Facebook profile. Yeah. Yes. Yeah, I know you may not believe it, but it's true. And I think even you too, you will get to a point where you will fill in such a form. Okay, so how to fill in a form? Number one, plan what you have to say. Okay, yes, plan what you have to say. You don't just write. A form is very important. You do not just write. You know, you plan what you have to say there. Number two, draft your answers, especially those where you are asked to write in complete sentences, okay? So if there is a form where you may need to write a paragraph, please just take a page and draft it somewhere first, okay? Draft it somewhere first to make sure that you do not make a mistake. Because in many forms, if it happens that you've made a mistake and you scratch it out, you can be disqualified. Your form will function as a saucer to someone at work. Someone will drink a coffee, someone will drink tea on your form, I tell you. So please just draft your complete sentences on a page. And then when you are sure that this is what you want to write, when you're sure that your sentence will be able to fit in the space provided in the form, then you can transfer it, you can transcribe it to the form. Okay, please, this is very important. Please, this is very important. Then remember to use the process writing method. Remember to use the process writing method. Okay, so this means that after you have drafted those complete sentences or that paragraph, please edit it, okay? Proofread it and present what you've written, okay? So remember that when you give in this form, you know, when I was working in the office, I was not a teacher, all right? I was not a teacher, so I was not going to have a red pen and then underline there and correct your spelling. No, if I see that, you know, this person, this one, they cannot even write about themselves. If then you cannot write about yourself, what do you expect us to do with your application? Maybe then I tear it because there are too many applications, you know. So please make things easy for yourself. Make things easy for whoever will be processing your form or your application, okay? Remember, I mean, during that time when I was processing forms, I never had a red pen because I was not a teacher. I never had a red pen to circle spelling errors, to circle your LOLs and whatever, you know. It is only now as a teacher where I get to use a red pen. But during those times, no. The red pen, maybe I was only using it to sort out that, okay, these ones, they are bad, but maybe we may consider them if we have space. Okay, so please make things easy for yourself. Do not disqualify yourself. All right, here is an example of a filled-in form. I hope everyone can see it. So there it is, an example of a filled-in form. Right. So anyway, I will not say too much about who that person who filled in is. Anyway, this is just for illustrative purposes to show you how to fill in a form, right? So in this form, this person was applying for a position, okay? So like, okay, here there was this organization, it was looking for someone who can be part of the organization to be able to help people in rural areas, okay? Yes. Okay, so here we are here. So anyway, here we are here. Okay, so that is the name. Okay, you fill in the name. So here it says the age. In the age, it says tick the relevant box. So since she's somewhere between 11 and 15, she made a cross here. So usually here it's either you tick or you cross. It will depend on what the form says. So if it happened that happiness was 20 years old, then happiness didn't qualify. She's not supposed to even fill in this form. But then since happiness is somewhere between 11 and 15, that's what she did. She crossed 11 to 15. And happiness is a girl, therefore she crossed in F to show that she is a girl, she's female. All right. So anyway, here it talks about the subject she studied at school. There she wrote them EMS, NS, EMS, you know, EMS, natural science and social science. Then here she also had to circle the language she did. She did English. All right. And okay, so she did English. All right. Then she didn't have any other subject, so she left it blank. But usually you can just write NA, meaning non-applicable. And then another question here, in what sporting activities do you participate? She's the person who does hockey. Therefore, she wrote hockey. Okay, and she made sure that the spelling for hockey is correct. All right, yes. And okay, remember, if it happens that hockey has a slang, please do not write the slang for hockey. Okay, please do not write the slang for hockey. Write the name of the sport itself. You know hockey to be hockey, so write it as hockey, you know. I know that some sports have nicknames. For example, soccer, people they call soccer disky. Okay, so then if you write disky there, you are shooting yourself in the foot. Just write soccer or just write football. Okay, don't write disky. No. Disky is a slang for soccer. So remember I said use formal language. And then the next question asks, are you a member of any sporting team? Circle either yes or no. So here she circled no, okay? She circled no because she's not a member of any sporting team, right? So then if it happened that she circled yes here, then she had to write the name of the sporting team here. Okay, so remember that is how you follow these instructions. Since she circled no, then she didn't have to write anything here because here you only answer if the answer there is yes. Okay, so here it says cycle. Since it says cycle, please do not underline. Okay, do not underline it there because it says cycle. If it says cycle, please cycle. Then it asks again, are you involved in any cultural activities? Cycle yes or no. So she cycled yes. So because she cycled yes, there it says if yes, specify. Then she specified public speaking. All right. So what is your favorite subject at school? So her favorite subject at school is English, okay? So if your favorite subject at school is mathematics, please don't write English. Write mathematics. Thank you. So here it says, list your hobbies or interests. So she wrote them there. Bird watching, comma. Hiking. Okay, sorry about that. So anyway, here it is about how she sees herself, you know. Sometimes you can say that you are friendly, but people who know you, they can say that you are the most unfriendliest person ever. Okay. So in this case, since it asks about how, since it says how you are, about how you could describe yourself, I mean, you know, that is how people are. If you can ask them to tell you about themselves, they will only tell you good things about themselves. Okay. Yeah. So anyway, that is what she did there. She says she's friendly. Even if it could help, she says she's friendly. I know she is friendly, but then I'm just saying that sometimes a person cannot be friendly, but then they can say they are friendly. You know, yes, it happens. And then another question in the form, it says, what can you contribute to this particular outreach program? She says, I feel like making a difference in the world. Okay, so you realize that, okay, that is a good answer for this question. The last question, write one sentence about why you think you will be suitable candidate for this outreach program. She said, I am passionate about helping people, you see? So you can see there that she has followed the instruction. There it says, write one sentence, okay? So please do not write a paragraph. Please do not write a paragraph. They say one sentence. So since they say one sentence, please write one sentence, okay? Do not write a paragraph. If you feel like writing a paragraph, just write the paragraph on the side and think about how you can reduce that paragraph into a sentence. Okay, yes. So there they said one paragraph, so she had to write one paragraph. She said, I'm passionate about helping people. So there they want the date. Okay, so yeah, she used the correct date, the 30th of June 2020. And that is her signature right there. Okay, so that is how we fill a form. Okay, you see, it is very exciting. It's very amazing. The greatest thing about filling in a form is when they call you and they say that your form and they say that your form or your application has been correct. So these are the questions you should ask yourself when you fill in a form. Yeah, I'm about to wrap up now. So these are the questions you should ask yourself after filling in a form. Okay, before you send it wherever it needs to go, please ask yourself these questions and please be honest. Okay, it is bad enough that people are lying to you. So please, please, please do not lie to yourself, okay? It is very sad when it is yourself who's lying to yourself. So please do not lie to yourself, okay? Other people can laugh at you, can lie at you, and you really have not much control over that, okay? But you really have control at what you tell yourself. So please, please, please do not lie at yourself when you answer these questions, okay? Number one, do I always follow instructions carefully when I fill in a form? If the answer is no, then please go back to your form. Check it again. See if you answered the question the way at which you really needed to answer them. Okay. Number two, do I provide the correct details when I'm asked to provide information? Correct. You know, if you're born in 24 July, please make sure that you wrote 24 July, not 18 July. Thank you. The next one, do I use formal language? Make sure that you used formal language. There's no slang, there's no LOL and all those things. The last question, ask yourself, do I avoid using slang and contractions? Contractions is words such as can't, okay? So please avoid them. Okay, avoid them. Please avoid them. So these are the questions you need to ask yourself and answer. So anyway, we are done with the lesson. Remember, filling in forms and questionnaires is a very crucial skill, especially for your academic and professional life. Thank you so much for joining us today. I hope you have enjoyed the lesson as much as I've enjoyed giving it. I hope that now you are at a place where you feel confident and you are ready to fill in every form that which can be given to you. So may you enjoy the rest of the day. Enjoy your Friday. May you have a wonderful, safe, enjoyable weekend. Okay, remember, if you go somewhere, please wear your mask and remember social distancing. Please wash your hands regularly with soap and water or use a hand sanitizer. Stay home, stay safe, enjoy your weekend. From all of us here at STEM Digital School, we love you. Goodbye. Take care. Remember, provide correct information in your forms. use the formal language, use everything that which you learned about here. I wish you all the best in every form that which you are going to fill in your life. And let us meet again on Monday, same time, same place. Goodbye, bye-bye, take care.